Hello, my cute buddies. This is your English tutor. I'm so happy to come up with an interesting session today. English Lesson 3 in a Nutshell Part 4. Let me take you to the next level of grammar to enrich your brain. Create sentences using plurals. Irregular plural nouns. Irregular plural nouns are nouns that do not become plural by adding s or es as most nouns. Generally, in plural nouns, we are adding s or es, or sometimes we are changing ies, vs. But in this irregular plural nouns, we cannot use it like that. Irregular plural nouns are made plural by changing vowels, changing the word, or adding a different ending. Now you can see the example here. Goose. Now how we can change this into plural form? Geese. This is irregular plural. Now here are some examples for you children. A man. So for this plural, how we can change? Men. M-E-N, men. So vowel we are changing here. A person, people, a tooth, teeth, a mouse, mice. Likewise, a woman. So how we can change this? A woman. Okay. Next, a foot. See, the plural form for foot is feet. A child, only one, and here so many we are writing here. Children. And ox. Oxen. So these are few examples for you children. Next. So here it is an exercise given in your book. Sheep. Okay. Singular and plural form for sheep is the same. Sheep. So here we cannot add here yes. This is the rule in grammar. Same sheep is coming here. Now singular form of sheep is, the sheep is grazing in the field. So here we are create sentence using the sheep. Next, the plural form, the sheep are grazing in the field. So when it is many, we are using here verb are. So here we are using here verb is. Okay, now deer, D-E-E-R, deer. Singular and plural form for deer is the same, deer. So how we are writing here sheep, likewise we are writing here deer. Now for singular you are going to create a sentence. Here it is, a deer is grazing in the field. You can see only one deer is grazing in the field. When it is many, how we can write this? The deer are grazing in the field. Next, tooth. Here the vowel are changing. Okay, T-O-O-T-H, tooth, and the plural form is teeth, T-E-E-T-H, teeth. Now you are going to create sentence. He has a fallen tooth in his hand. You can see here the boy is having fallen tooth. Now the plural form they have already given. We must brush our teeth twice a day. Okay, children. Now, goose. Here we are changing the vowel geese. So we are going to create sentence. The goose is in the pool. You can see the goose is in the pool, or the goose is swimming in the pool. Now, the plural form. The geese are in the pool. You can see so many are there, so we are writing here the geese. Next, foot. Here also we are going to change the vowel, feet. Now the singular they have given the sentence, the boy's foot is in the water. For the plural we are going to write, can you guess anything children? Here is the answer. The girl is pouring water to her feet. You can see she is pouring water. Now for singular, man. Here we are changing the vowel men. A man is at the door. For the plural, the men are at the door. Okay. Next. Singular form, child. Adding a different ending. Here the ending is different. Children. Child, children. Now, here is the sentence. A child is playing football. Now, for the plural, the children are playing football. Now, you can find the difference. Is for singular, we are using the verb. And or for plural, we are using the children are playing football. Then next, person. Change the vowel, we are going to change. People. When it is many, how we can say them? People. For singular, a person is walking on the road. See, one person is walking on the road, so we are writing like this. When it is many, how we can write? Many people are waiting at the bus stop. Okay, now see this. Mouse, only one. We are changing the word. Totally the word is changing. Here also, totally the word is changing. Mice. The mouse is eating cheese. And you can create a sentence. The mice are eating cheese. Or you find a difference, children? Yes. Here is we are using for singular form of verb. Here are we are using. Next. Here is the activity. Look deep. Read these sentences aloud. Sentence 1. The sheep is in the barn. You can see this. The sheep are in the barn. Okay. So for singular we are using sheep. For plural also we are using sheep. Underline the irregular plural noun and circle the verb in each of the sentence. You have to underline it and circle it. In the sentence 1, the singular verb is is, indicates that there is single sheep in a barn. Plural verb are in sentence 2 tells us that there is more than one sheep in the barn. In such sentences, the verb indicates whether the noun is in the singular or plural form. See, observe this, we can able to see the singular and plural. Okay. Next. Choose one animal in figure 9. Compare the characteristics of these animals with those of humans. Some animals that you may compare are appearance, food habits, size and weight, habitat. So here you are going to write. So first example they have already given, same different. Humans eat plants. A deer eats grass, twigs and other plants too. Humans eat meat. A deer does not. So here you can write the similar activities of animals and humans, and in this place you can write the different activities. Okay. One example I can give to you. Humans can swim. The goose also can swim in the water. Geese can fly. Humans cannot fly. These are the differences. So likewise, you can find the similarities and difference between these two. And you can take the singular form of noun and plural form for this. Okay, children? Do this in your home and write the answers in your studios. Now, complete the concept map with examples and sentences. Irregular plural nouns with different ending. So, the word with different ending. What is the answer? Child, children. See, the ending is different. So, how can we create the sentence? Yes. The children are playing in the park. Now, with same singular and plural form, you can observe same singular and plural form. What it is? Yes, sheep. Sheep in singular form and sheep in plural form. Now the sentence for this, the sheep are grazing in the field. Now has new word. So totally the word has been changed here. What are they? Yes, person, people. It is totally changed. Now see the answer. Many people are waiting at the bus stop. Okay, children, write the answers in your studios. Next, it is a companion activity. You can take your companion book and just do the activity. What they have said, with the help of your parents, reflect on what you can eat every day in figure A. Indicate the time and list the foods that you usually eat through the day. So breakfast, at which time you can eat, you can draw the hands in the clock and write what food items you can eat. Snacks, at which time you can take the snacks, write the snacks name. And lunch, which time you are taking the lunch, write the lunch name. And again, evening snacks, write the snacks name. And dinner time, at which time you are having your dinner, you can write the dinner name here, dish name here. Okay, children, are you clear? So write this in your companion. Next, answer the following questions. Which is your favorite food? You can write the answer. And why that food is favorite to you, that also you can write here. Which is the healthiest meal that you can eat? So you can write the healthiest meal. Do you eat a lot of junk or fried food? Go back to your food table and find out. List foods here. So you have to write it. Then next, here is a exercise part. This is also in your companion. Okay, so unscribble the words given in the brackets, filling the blanks with these plural nouns. One has been done for you. Three mice. Here the word is jumbled. You can write the correct word. Three mice ran across the kitchen. Those. Das or making a lot of noise. Those. So how we can write this? People. Those people are making a lot of noise. Next. The monkey removes das from its baby's head. So here is the answer, people. Here is the lease. And my das are dirty. What you can say this? My feet are dirty. Next. The das are grazing in the farm. What will be the answer? The oxen are grazing in the farm. What is the singular form of each of these plural nouns? Write them here. So you can write the singular form for these words. What are they? Yes. Mouse, person, loose, foot, ox. Okay, children. Now, write the plural form of each noun given in pictures. Write the sentence each using the plural forms in this space provided. Now you can see this. Teeth. For the teeth, you can write the sentence. We brush our teeth regularly. So whatever sentence you can write, that may be right. Next, sheep. What picture it is? Sheep. Now you can create the sentence. The sheep are grazing in the field. Okay, children. Next, see what you can see here. Deer. Deer. And make the sentence using this deer. The deer feed on plants. You can see the deer feeds on plants. Next, what you can see here? Feet. I wash my feet every day. So every day you are going to wash your feet. Okay, children. Next, let us play a game. So here is a game. So here, what I have given, you have to working things. You just write the answer in the companion book. Okay. Singular noun. Write the noun in its plural form and frame a sentence of your own using it. So you have to write it. Man. So for this man, you can. What will be the plural form for man? Men. Okay, children. So you have to write the sentence. The men are walking in the park. Next, singular form for woman. What is the singular form for plural form for woman is women. Now the sentence you can create, the women are waiting in the railway stations, or whatever answer you can write, that is right. So write this sentence. Next, fish. Singular form is fish. and the plural form for fish is the same fish. Whether it may be a different variety or different size, you can write your fishes. So you have to write the sentence. The fish are swimming in the water. Next, fourth one, singular noun, goose. What is the plural noun for goose? Geese. So you have to make the sentence. The geese are eating worms. Okay, likewise children, here 5th, 6th and 7th, I have given the words. Child, children, you can create the sentence. Deer, deer, so you can create the sentence here. Person, people, you can create the sentence of your own children. So write the answer in your companion. Likewise, 8th one, ox, oxen, you can create your own sentence using the word oxen. Likewise, 9th one, tooth, and the plural form of tooth is teeth. So here you can make the sentence. 10th one, singular noun, mouse, and the plural noun is mice. You can create the sentence. Okay children, so the sentence may be different, that is, that depends upon your creativity. So thank you children. Write your answers in your companion as well as in your studio. Learn the grammar part well, children.